Imagine you have created a popular application with a growing user base. Users are signing up daily and server events happen as they browse the site, like sending email notifications. However, sending emails can take time, and it's not a good experience for users to be blocked while waiting for these processes to complete. For our application to scale effectively, we need a way to handle these events away from the critical path of a request. This is where event-driven architecture comes in. Hi, I'm Herschel, and in this video, I will demonstrate how to build an event-driven application using Cloudflare Queues. Event-driven system lets you decouple services, allowing them to process and scale independently. This approach helps you create high-performance applications by ensuring no part of the system is blocked while a request is being processed. Let's dive into the demo. I have created a simple e-commerce application where users can sign up with their email address, add products to the cart, and place orders. As a new user, I can sign up with an email address and a password. Now keep an eye on the terminal. As soon as I hit the sign up button, you will see some logs. The log message says that a new user signed up and that it's sending a message to the queue with a user ID and a timestamp. When a new user signs up, a message is sent to a user session queue. The queue consumer will process the message once it hits the max timeout value or the max batch value. It will retrieve the user information from the database and use resend to send a welcome email like the one I'm going to show you next. Now, as you can see, a new email was sent to this email address, and we just sent a new user a welcome email. How cool is that? A user wants to continue with the shopping. A user can browse products and add them to their cart. So let's head back to our application. Let's just say that the user is interested in buying a smartphone and maybe a smartwatch. The user can go to the cart, change the quantity of the products if they want, and then place an order. Once an order is placed, you can see that another event got triggered and we get an order placed successful message over here. But let's take a look at the code and see how this actually works behind the scenes. When a user places an order, an API call is made to our endpoint /API/order. With this API call, we are sending in the information of the order, the time this order was placed, and the user ID. We pass on this information as a message to our order queue. Now the consumer worker for this queue is gonna use the handle order function to handle this incoming message. The first thing is we are configuring resend, and then we are looping through the messages coming in the batch. We are extracting out the body of the message and then passing on the user ID to our database to grab the username and the email. Next, we are fetching the information of the product, like the product name and its description, from our products table. Once we have the information of the user and the products, we use resend to send the order confirmation email. I already have a order confirmation template in which I am passing the username, the order time, and the list of products the user have ordered. A function was able to successfully send an email. We acknowledge that message. If not, we log the error message and we tell our worker to retry this message after a delay of 100 seconds. So let's go back to our recent dashboard and see how the message looks like. We have now the order confirmation message, and it tells us what products we ordered, at what quantity, and at what time. By offloading these tasks to the queues, we ensure that users can interact seamlessly with the application while still receiving relevant notifications. This approach significantly improves the application's performance and scalability. Cloudflare queues are now generally available, offering increased limits and improved performance. I hope this demo has inspired you to explore how queues can enhance your application. Thank you, and see you in the next one.